हेलो एवरीवन, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे सप्लाई. सो व्हाट इज सप्लाई? सप्लाई मींस व्हेन द ऑल द फैक्टर्स रिमेनिंग कांस्टेंट एट अ पर्टिकुलर प्राइस एंड अ पर्टिकुलर टाइम, द विलिंगनेस एंड अ कैपेसिटी ऑफ द फर्म टू सेल द गुड्स इज कॉल्ड सप्लाई. सो वी कैन से दैट फॉर एग्जाम्पल द प्रोड्यूसर हैज 1000 यूनिट्स but he is not ready to sell the 500 units. He is ready to sell only 500 unit. Then the 500 unit is known as a supply. Okay. For example, if producer wants to sell 1000 unit but he is having only 500 unit in stock, then also the supply is only 500 units. Okay. So when we can say when the other factors are constant and a readiness and a willingness of producer to sell goods is known as supply. The supply of good can be less than or equals to the stock of good, and there is a difference between the supply and sale, because supply of goods is the probability of selling, and whereas selling is a reality. Now we will see the factors that are affecting the supply. First is price, next cost of production, natural factor, price of substitutable commodities, facilities of loan, government policies, expectations of future. Now see, first price. Price is the most important factor of any area, you can say. So when the other factors remain the constant, and if the price of the goods is increased, then supply of goods is also increased. And if the price of goods is decreased, then supply also decreased. Thus, the price affect the stock and the production of goods and influence the supply in the market. Now, these are the other factors which affect the, other than the price, which affect the supply. In that, the cost of production. So production affects the supply most, and production depends on the cost of production. If the price of the commodity is a constant, but the factors which are included for the production, if the cost of that is varies, then supply is also affected. For example, interest paid on the capital, or rent is increased or decreased, then it will become a quite thinkable that whether it producer have to supply more or they have to supply less. If it will price of cost of production increase, then supply decrease, because it lessers the profitability of the firm. And if the cost of production decreases, then supply increases. Next is natural factor. Natural factors like the earthquake, cyclone, heavy rains, these factors affect the supply of the commodities. Because if example we can say, supply of the vegetable nowadays we can see, for example. So in between we had seen recently that rain occurs for 2 to 4 days. So that time supply of the vegetables has been affected, and after that the price of vegetables is also goes high, and at a particular that time supply is also decreased. So natural factors affect the supply of also. If there is an adverse climate, then supply decreases, and if there is a favorable climate, then supply of particular goods will increase. Next is price of substitutable commodities. So change in the price of other substitutable commodities also affect the supply of particular commodity. For example, if the price of millet remains the constant but the price of cotton increases, then farmer will reduce the production of bajri and supply of bajri will decrease, and he will grow more cotton and increase the supply of cotton. Next is credit facilities, or you can say facilities of loan. So to do any business, one need a fund, and they can raise a fund by taking a loan. So if a producer obtain a credit facility or a loan at a lower rate, okay, then the capital will increase, and with the product, with it also increases the production. So supply also increases. But if they are getting finance at a higher cost, which is for which they have to pay a high rate of interest, then the cost of production increases. And as there is an inverse relationship between cost of production supply, so supply of production also is decreasing. Next is government policies. Government policies are changing day by day for particular reasons. And so if government is levying taxes on a production or a selling of the commodities, then supply is also affected because they have to pay more on per selling or supplying or production of that particular commodity. And on the other hand, if government announces subsidy or relief in a tax for any commodities production, then production will increase, and as a result of increase in a production, supply will also increases. Next and last is expectation of future price. If there is a rumors of in rumor in the market that the supply of commodity or price or a market situation, okay, because of any reason there is a rumor that price of any particular commodity will rise, then producer will increase his stock, not supply. He will retain his stock that so that he can supply it more in a future and get more profit. So thus expectations about future price of commodity also affect the supply. Next is law of supply. As we had seen, law of demand. So there is an inverse relationship between demand and a price. But here you can see there is a same relation between the price and supply. As price increases, supply also increases, and price decreases, supply also decreases when other factors are constant. So this is law of supply. So we can see that all the factors remaining constant and at a particular time, the willingness and capacity of the firm to sell the goods is known as called a supply. So it explains that raise in price, raise in supply, and decrease in price reduces the supply of goods. So there is a same directional change in the price and supply. And next is assumptions of supply. Assumptions regarding what are the assumptions that we had seen, that other factors which are affecting the supply are the constant, okay, and only price is changing. Next, we will see the schedule diagram and schedule graph of a supply. See, but price of goods X is 10 to increasing to 50, 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. And at that particular price, the supply of goods is 100, 200, 300, 400, and 500. So, and if you plot a graph for this, X-axis shows the supply, Y-axis shows the price. Then if you plot this point at a 10 price, 100 quantity demand supply, 20, 200, 30, 300, and so on. So A, B, C, D are a supply. So if you draw a line, then you can see it is an upward slope. Okay. So, and you had seen the demand curve is, that is a downward slope. So you can see with the increase in price, demand supply of the goods also increases. Here there is a positive slope we can see. By the time as price increase, supply increases. Here our this topic ended.